Good morning. Today we'll discuss the 8-bit subtraction using microcontroller 8051. Write an assembly language program to subtract two numbers of 8-bit data stored in memory 8500H and 8501H. Store the magnitude of the result in 8502. If the result is positive, store 00 in 8503H. Or if the result is negative, store 01 in 8503H. Data 1 and data 2, the two data load into external memory 8500 and 8501, and the result difference and borrow to store difference in 8502, if any borrow to store 8503H. All the data and all the result to store only external memory address locations. For that, we have to initialize the data pointer. The given external memory address. Now, the given two 8-bit data, now to subtract. In microcontroller, if you are using the subtract instruction, it will subtract with borrow also. Accumulator content, register data with borrow status also. Before subtraction, we have to clear the carry status. And also to clear any one register for to store the borrow status. Load the data 1 in 8500. That data to move only accumulator 09H. Next, load the second data in address 8501. For that, to increment the memory address. Now the second data also available in data pointer. The data pointer data to move only the accumulator. For that, the first data to move some other register. Suppose A register data to move R1. Now register R109H. And then increment the memory, the second data to move accumulator. Now accumulator 03. Register R109 and register A register 03. Before that, we have to clear the carry. What is the instruction for to clear the carry? CLRC. Now the carry status will be clear. Why means? In subtraction instruction, we have to subtract with borrow also. For that, we have to clear the carry status initially. As well as to clear any one register, suppose R0 register 00H. This is for to store the carry status. First, we have to subtract minus with the subtrahend. The minus 8500 data subtract with the 8501 data. The first data available R1 and the second data available accumulator. But in subtract instruction, we have to subtract the accumulator with the register content. Always first data will be accumulator content. For that, we have to exchange we have to exchange these two data. We have to exchange these two data. For that, we can use the instruction exchange. XC exchange. Now the accumulated data 09 and the registered data R103. Now data will be exchanged. After exchange, we have to subtract these two data. 09 00001001. Next 03 00000011. Now to subtract these two data, 1 minus 1 0, 0 minus 1 we cannot subtract. So we have to get borrow from here. Now 1 0 1 0 means 2 2 minus 1 1, and here 1 will be available. 1 minus 0 1, and here 0. Now the 1 will be moved in to this position. So here the 0 will be available. 0 minus 0 0 0 minus 0 0 minus 0 0 minus 0 0 minus 0. Now accumulated result 06. Now after subtraction, it will subtract accumulator register with carry status also. For that only to clear initially carry 00. Now after subtraction, the accumulator result 06. Now to check whether the result is negative or positive. Okay, if result is no carry, if result is accumulator content is no carry, when the carry flag will be set condition. Now to subtract these two data, get some borrow from outer side of the 8-bit, outer side of the 8-bit. At that time the carry flag will be set condition. Or accumulator content is less than register content, at that time the carry flag will be set condition. Now result is negative result. In microcontroller, there is no separate sign for to indicate the negative sign. Then how to indicate? Now the result is negative. For that, we have to use the 2's complement method. Okay? We have to use the 2's complement method. Now the negative result to change into positive result. Positive result. Now result will be changed positive. Then how to indicate the negative? After complement, after 2's complement, we have to increment the carry register content single times. We have to increment the carry register content single times. When the carry register content 1, now result is negative result. When the carry register content 0, now result is positive result. This case, accumulator content 09 and register content 03. Now to subtract these two data and to check the carry status. Here the carry flag will be reset condition. Why? The accumulator content is greater than register content. Now the carry flag will be reset. When the carry flag is reset, now result is positive. If result is positive, that accumulator content 06. That 06 data to store 8502 address. This is called difference. And the next address location, we have to store the borrow 00. That 00 available R0 register. Now the R0 register data to move accumulator, and then accumulator data to move the given data pointer address 850300. This is the concept of to subtract to 8-bit data. Suppose if accumulator content 03 and register content 09. Accumulator content 03 and register content 09. Now to subtract these two data, 0000. 0011. Next 0000910001. Now to subtract these two data, 1 minus 1, 0, 1 minus 0, 1, 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 1. We have to get borrow from here. The within 8 bit, there is no 1s. So we have to get from outer side. We have to get the 1 from outer side. Now this is for 1, 0. 1, 0 means 2. 2 minus 1, 1. And the remaining digits will be 1 condition. 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 0, 1. Now, get borrow from outer side. At that time, the carry flag will be set condition. Or, if D7 bit is 1. If D7 bit is 1, now the sign flag will be set condition. That result is negative. That result is negative. Now, how to change the negative result into positive? We have to use the 2's complement method. In 2's complement method, now the formula 2's complement equal to 1's complement plus 1. 1's complement plus 1. Now, this is the accumulated result. We have to take the 1's complement. 1's complement means 1 change into 0 and 0 change into 1. This is for 1. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. And this is for 0 and this is for 1. After that, add plus 1. Add plus 1. Yeah, the 1's complement, we have to use the instruction for CPLA. Complement the accumulator content. Next, 2's complement, we have to add 1's complement result with 0, 1. We have to add 0, 1. For that, we can use INCA. Increment the 1's increment the 1's complement result once. We have to add 1 here. 1, 1, 0 and carry here. 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. This result is 0, 6. Now the negative result change into positive result. 0, 6. This 0, 6 result to store 8502 address. And then we have to increment the carry register content single times. After complement. After complement. Now the carry register content will be incremented single times. Okay. Next address location, we have to store the carry results. For that, the carry result available R0. Now the R0 data to move accumulator and then accumulator data to move 8503 address. Now the carry here 1. If 8500003 data and 850109 data. Minus 03, subtract 09 and difference 06 and borrow 01. Now difference 06 and borrow 1 means now result is minus 6. Minus 6. If borrow 0 means now result is positive 06. This is the concept to subtract the two 8-bit data. For this concept, we have to write the program. Okay. First, to clear the carry status. For that, we can use CLRC. CLRC means to clear the carry status. Now, carry will be 0. After that, to clear any one register for to store the carry results. For that, we can clear R0 register. Move R0, comma, hash 00 H. Now, the 00 data immediately to move R0 register. Now, R0 will be 00. This is for to store the carry purpose. Next, load the data 8500 and 8501. This is for external memory address allocation. What is the instruction for to initialize external memory address location? For that we can use MOV data pointer DPTR:8500H. Now 8500 00, this is for LSB, it will be stored into DPN, and 85, this is for most significant 8-bit, this will be stored into DPH. These two represent for DPTR, data pointer. Now the first data available, 8500 external memory address location, we have to move only accumulator. For that we can use instruction MOVNX A comma at the rate of DPTR. At the rate of DPTR means the data pointer address location data to indirectly to move accumulator content. Now accumulator will be 03. Next, the accumulator data we have to move temporarily some other register. MOV R1 comma A. Why? We have to load the second data. The second data also we have to move the only accumulator. Now the first data will be erased. For that, the first data temporarily we have to move to any one of the register. Next, increment the data pointer address. For that we can use INC DPTR. Now data pointer will be incremented once. Now the data pointer address at present 8501. Now that address location data we have to move only accumulator. So we can use the same instruction MOV X A comma at the rate of DPTR. Now the data pointer address location data indirectly to move accumulator. Now accumulator 09 and the register R1 03. In subtraction, we have to subtract accumulated data register with carry. So first data always in accumulator. First data always in accumulator. Now here the first data available R1, the second data will be accumulator. Now how to move the first data to accumulator and the second data to R1? For that we can use exchange instruction XCH means exchange the accumulator content comma R1 data. Now R1 data to move accumulator and then accumulator data to move R1 register. Okay, after exchange we have to subtract accumulator register with borrow status also. For that we can use instruction SBB A comma R1. Subtract accumulator register with carry status also. After subtraction we have to check the result whether it is carry or not. Okay, for that we can use JNC jump if the result is no carry. No carry means directly jump to here. Okay, directly jump to here we can to store the accumulator result. Now accumulator result will be positive. That positive result called difference. Difference we have to store the next address of data pointer. Further we have to increment the data pointer address DPTR. Now address will be incremented. Now in this address location we have to move the accumulator result, that is difference MOVX at the rate of DPTR comma A, at the rate of DPTR comma. Now accumulator result 06 difference will be available. That difference data to move data pointer address 8502. Now difference store. After that we have to store the borrow. The borrow available or zero register. Okay, at present 00. Now the 00 data we cannot directly to move the data pointer address. Okay. Now the registered data. First we have to move the accumulator. MOV A comma R1. R1 data. Sorry, R0 data. R0 data to move accumulator. Okay. After that to increment the data pointer address. INC DB PR. Next we can move MOV X at the rate of DPTR comma A. Accumulator content to move the next address of data pointer 00 and alter the program. Instead of alt, we have to use the microcontroller short jump. Yes, jump JMP, jump to last memory address location itself. When if result is positive, that is no carry. Okay, now the accumulator content 03 and the register content 09. Now to subtract these two data, for this case the carry flag will be set condition. The carry flag will be set condition means now result is positive result. In microcontroller there is no symbol for to indicate the negative sign. Now how to indicate now the result is positive? For that we have to use the 2's complement method. After 2's complement result, the negative result to change into positive, and then we have to increment the carry register content single times. Now the carry register content will be 1. When the carry register content 1, now result is negative result. When the carry result is 0, now result is positive. Now for this case, the carry flag will be set condition. Set means we have to use 2's complement. The accumulator result after subtraction, the accumulator result is negative. We have to change into positive. For that 2's complement, first we have to use 1's complement, CTN A. This is 1's complement result. After complement A, now accumulator will be available 1's complement result. After that we have to add the 01 in accumulator. For that we can use INC A, increment the accumulator content. Okay, this is for 1's complement and this is for 2's complement. After that we have to increment the carry register content single times, INC or 0. After that increment the data pointer. Now address will be incremented 8501 to 8502. Now the negative result to change into positive result 06. After that carry status will be available R0. Now R0 data to move accumulator. Now increment 101 data to move accumulator, and then increment data pointer. After that accumulator result to move data pointer address 8503 01, and short jump end of the program. This is the concept for to subtract the two 8-bit data. First we have to clear the carry status. For that we can use CL or C. And second one, we have to clear any one register data to store the carry purpose, and then load data 1, data 2. Okay, and then exchange these two datas. Why means, first we have to subtract the first data with the second data. For that we have to exchange the data. After exchange we have to subtract the two datas. After that to check the result whether it is carry or not. If result is no carry, we can directly to store the difference in 8502 address, and carry will be 00 to store the next address 8503 address, and short jump. If result is carry means result is negative result. So we have to convert into positive result. After that to indicate the carry will be 1. For that we have to use the 2's complement method. First 1's complement and then add 01. After that, to increment the carry register content single frames. Now the negative result, that is minus 6, will be changed into positive 6. Then how to indicate the result is negative means, if borrow 1, borrow is 1, now result is minus 6. If borrow is 0, result is positive result 06. That's all. Any doubt? No. Thank you.